Welcome everyone, welcome to this small video, introductory video, where we will try to understand that what kind of career does a MSBI developer have, what is the prospect of MSBI, and should people take this as a career or not, and second, what kind of people can take MSBI as a career and how to go about learning MSBI. Right, so in order to first understand the job market of MSBI, what I've done is I have opened up this very famous portal of India, naukri.com, and on this, you know, I will go and search MSBI. Now, whatever I'm doing on this site over here, it is focused on India, but you can very well go and search on your country's famous job portals, and I'm sure that the results should not vary too much. So I have searched MSBI, and you can see that I have only got 2,300 results. Now, the first thing which will come to your mind is, oh, only 2,000 jobs across this big country, India. So, is this MSBI really worth as a career or not? So, first thing, let me clarify you that MSBI is not such a small market. It's a big chunk of market. Actually, what happens in MSBI is that you have three sections. One is SSIS. Other one is SSAS, and the last one is SSRS, and the job market is divided into one of these three sections. So when a company places a requirement, you know, he says that, okay, I need a SSIS developer, and sometimes he does not want SSAS and SSRS, right? So definitely as an MSBI developer, you should be knowing all of these three. But you know, from the job aspect or from the job perspective, a lot of projects, you know, just use SSIS, or they just use SSAS, or they just use SSRS. And there are some projects, you know, who actually use all the three of them. So if you want to really analyze the job market of MSBI, then you should be searching all of these three keywords as well, right? So let me do a comma here and say, okay, let us search with SQL Server Integration Services. Let us also add SQL Server Reporting Services. And let us also add SQL Server Analysis Services. So let us add all three of them. And let us do a search. So now if you do a search, you can see now we have 23,000 jobs. So that is 10 times more, right? So better, right? Good. Also, I would like to emphasize a very important point here. The job distribution between SSIS and SSAS and SSRS, they vary in a very huge manner. Maximum number of jobs are available in SSIS and SSRS. So maximum times you will see that people either want SSIS, they want SSRS, or they want both of them. You have very, very less jobs in SSAS. Why so? Because SSAS is used for analysis purposes. So that's why, you know, the jobs which are there in SSAS, they will normally be for bigger companies, you know, like JP Morgan, you know, must be Morgan Stanley or Wells Fargo. So big banks, big financial institutions actually use SSAS, while SSIS and SSRS, you know, they can be used by smaller companies as well. So you will always find that the job market of SSIS and SSRS are large in numbers. The job market of SSAS is small in number, but remember, at the same time, we have very less good developers in SSAS, right? So that's how the distribution of MSBI jobs are. Okay, now let me discuss about, you know, that this whole job market again has two kind of MSBI developers. One kind of MSBI developers, I will term them as configurators actually. Configurators means they can drag and drop, you know, they can right click, they can go to properties, they understand MSBI, they know that what every property does, and they can complete a project. Okay, so this is one kind of MSBI developer, you know, who is a configurator, who understands basics and can work with MSBI and deliver project. But then there is another kind of MSBI developer who goes one step above, who says that I also know C Sharp and SQL Server very well. If you know C Sharp and SQL Server very well, then definitely it adds more value to MSBI. Okay, so there are two kind of people. One who just know MSBI, who just know how to drag and drop, execute a project, complete them. And the other one are bit above top of it, you can say advanced level, where they also know SQL Server very well, and they know C Sharp very well. So again, this job market is divided into these two categories. Now, if you just go and see this requirement here, you know, where I've searched, you can see if I just go and scroll below, let us say I scroll below. You can see this is 5 to 10 years of experience. If I just go and scroll below, 5 to 7 years, you know, and then 5 to 10 years, you will not find fresher MSBI as such. Means, for example, let us say, I don't know if you have a number of years of experience here, you know, so if I could have searched with number of years of experience, saying 0 years of experience, I don't think I will get such kind of a requirement. So in other words, the industry expects a MSBI person to be at least above 3 to 4 years of experience. Okay, that is a requirement. So now the next question which comes is, for people who are coming newly into this market, how should they go about it? So now the first thing for the freshers. So for the freshers, what you should try to achieve is, you should at least try to understand the basics of MSBI. You should be able to understand every property of MSBI, and you should know all the three legs of MSBI, and you should be in a mode, you know, where you can go and execute a project. So in other words, that first basic thing of MSBI, the basic level of MSBI, you should be knowing. So in case you know that, I'm sure that companies will you know, talk with you. And for people who are seniors, you know, for them, I think the roadmap is very clear. If you are a SQL Server DBA, I am dead sure MSBI adds value to you, because MSBI is a layer on SQL Server, right? So it definitely is a very integral part of SQL Server. So for SQL DBAs, I think this is a very, very great path. Now, for C# developers, it again adds value, because in MSBI, what happens is, you know, there are situations where you suddenly need some kind of a custom development. So for MSBI, C# and VB.NET is a programming language. So again, you know, when it comes to customization, C# and MSBI, people can add MSBI to their list as well, right? So for freshers, I think what you should do is, you should at least reach that basic level where you know all of these three technologies, where you know how to use them. And for people who are already in the market, who are already in the industry, so if you are a SQL Server DBA, I think this is the right choice for you. You should definitely go for it. And for C# developers, it definitely adds value, because remember that, you know, when you just say C#, right, you know, there are 1,000 requirements, right? And there are 10,000 people. Now, when you say C# with MSBI, then yes, the requirements are 100, but then you have 5 people. So the competition is equivalently less, right? So I think, you know, MSBI definitely adds a lot of value to your career, either a fresher or either as a senior. Now, I would like to make a very important point for people who are entering as freshers in the MSBI trade. Remember that, you know, at the basic level, once you know MSBI, once you know SSIS, SSAS, SSRS, how to configure the components, how to use them, you will get a job. But later on, when you say that, okay, now I want more salary, I want to skip, right, then you have to know C# and SQL very, very well. So remember that, you know, just don't learn MSBI. Must be, yes, I understand, job is very important, first get a job. But once you are inside the job, don't get into a comfortable position. You know, try to just learn C# as well as SQL. And people who are seniors, I think for them, the roadmap is very clear. I always feel if you're a SQL DBA, it is a must that you should know MSBI. And if you're a C# developer, I think it adds value. When you stand in a crowd, you know, you will be, you know, one of those niche crowds. You will stand, you know, where you have extra MSBI added to your CV. Now, the next question which comes is, so how do we learn MSBI? Now that we know that there is advanced and there is basic, you know, so where should we start from? The best way to learn MSBI so that you fetch job as soon as possible is by doing a project. Don't learn MSBI section by section. Don't say, okay, now I will learn SSIS only and I will learn SSAS. Learn it with a project. Understand the complete ecosystem, how these three things work with each other. So thinking from that perspective, what we have done is, we have floated a course called as Learn MSBI in 4 days. That means 32 hours. And in this, what we have done is, you know, in the 32 hours or 4 days of course, we have taught MSBI with a project. Okay, so we have taken a project and we started doing ETL, we started doing cube making, we have started doing reporting. So I would suggest you to follow that video. In case you are not aware where the video is, right where this video is playing down, we have put that link of Learn MSBI in 4 days. So you can go and click on that and start learning it right away now. So I hope that this video was useful. In this video, we try to understand what was MSBI, what is a job market, what are the various things people look at, you know, when you look at a MSBI developer, and from where to start. So best of luck and happy job hunting. Thank you so much.